The surprises keep coming again. I had no idea who was on or what. Bill Maher, what have you got for us now?
Well, it's not Saturday night, but live from New York, it's Larry King Live.
Thanks, Bill. You know, I've done about 7,000 interviews in my 25 years at CNN, and I've saved my best guest for last. I'm talking to me. Now, Larry, what's been my favorite interview?
It's hard to pick one out. You know, Larry?
Yeah.
Because you've done so many over the years, it's hard to pick one out. Every time I'm asked that, it's hard to pick one out. I like what you're wearing tonight, Larry.
Oh, thank you. You know, I just picked it out. You know, it was the first thing right there in the closet. It was great. Larry, what's the most interesting thing about me?
Most interesting thing about you
That
you're a little wacko. My sons were saying in the car tonight that no one is normal. In fact, if you met a normal person, he or she would be abnormal. So I would say that you're very special, Larry.
Well, thank you.
It's an
you're
honor
very
being inside of you.
It is, yes. It is an honor. Now, what question have I asked more than any over the years?
Why?
That's great.
No, that's been the, it's like the Abbott and Costello here. No, you see, the best question of all, Larry, is the question why.
I love
that question. Because it's a great question. Because it can't be answered in one word. And it forces the person to think.
Why?
It's also good if you're not paying attention. You can just say why.
Yeah, yeah.
As Ryan said, it's also good if you're not paying attention at the time.
You just say why.
Yeah, yeah.
Let's say you're being bugged on the end, someone's talking in your headset and you haven't heard, so you say why.
Why?
Yeah, sure. I know the feeling.
It's
great.
It's a minimalist. That's as you quoted.
I always say, Larry.
What now, Larry?
Now. Besides holding up my pants, why do I wear suspenders? Can the suspender industry survive the end of Larry King Live?
I will not stop wearing them. So, you've heard it first. No matter what I do in life, other things, the suspenders will remain. So, always. Larry, you can keep wearing them.
Thank you. I'm glad. I'm happy about that.
Now, listen, I've had weird things in my life, but this...
Fred Armisen as Larry King.
Way up on the list. I want to call him Fred. Yes,
Larry. Call me whatever you want. And now, was interviewing the cast of Saturday Night Live one of the most thrilling moments of my career?
Yes, it was. One, I was so impressed being in that studio because I like this set is historic. It's going to the Smithsonian. That set is historic. And when I sat there on that stage talking to them, and you weren't one of them. Why weren't you there?
Why?
Well,
why?
I was interviewing. Why? Why?
Why?
Now, Larry, what's the question nobody's ever asked me that I want to answer right now?
Boy, that's a tough one.
Unfly or zipper?
Is your zipper unflied? That's a Ryan Seacrest question. What's a Bill Maher question?
I don't think that's what he said.
No. Button fly or zipper.
Button fly or zipper.
You're very specific about that.
I hate button flies.
By the way, this is a serious issue for him.
You weren't asking if you do the show with your package out.
He's very specific about
that. Can I say something about this minimalist thing? Because I always said Larry's the ultimate minimalist, and we are losing the greatest minimalist of all time in this era, I think. You know, we're gonna miss that. Larry
thank you.
Larry would be great at speed dating. In 2 minutes, he could know everything. He elicits more information in a shorter amount of time than anybody
else. That's why he prefers the zipper over the button fly.
Right.
Zipper over button fly. And Ryan has gotten me gifts of jeans. And learn quickly.
Well, that's gay.
Zippers.
When you get another man jeans.
The suspenders and the jeans, and he says to me, I gotta have a zipper. When you gotta go with my age, you gotta go quick.
Yeah, I don't have these discussions with other men. But, you know, go ahead with your...
Hey, Fred, thanks a lot, Fred. Fred, I really appreciate you doing this. That was hysterical.
Thank you. Thank you.
We'll be back with America's best-known news anchors. They're all here. Next.
We'll be right back.
our guests, I just found out about them like 2 minutes before the show. We're showing you right now the Washington, D.C. control room with our staff there. Look at that crack staff. That's the staff in Washington. And now we'll switch to the staff right here in Los Angeles. There's the control room. There you see Wendy Walker and Greg Christensen. And next to Wendy is Cannon King. There's Sarah. And joining us now from New York, Katie Couric, the anchor of the CBS Evening News. Diane Sawyer, the anchor of ABC World News. My dear friend Barbara Walters, co-host and executive producer of The View. And Brian Williams, what a shock this is to me, anchor of NBC Nightly News. I was just told before the show that these guys are on. Diane, we'll start with you. You've been a guest on the show many times over the years, so I'll start by thanking you for coming tonight.
Thank you so much, and we are your protégés, your groupies, your pips here, as Gladys would say. But I want you to know, Larry, you said that you will never be without your suspenders when you're doing your specials, and we chipped together. It was really extravagant on our part. Right. But we want you to know you now have the official Larry King special suspenders, and on the back, we've got your back. All of us stayed up all night to stitch our names in. For you.
Wow.
So these are coming your way. These are your spruced up suspenders for your special.
I will wear them with honor and gratitude, and I thank you all very much.
Great.
Barbara, what's happening? Barbara Walters, I've been on The View many times, about 20 times, and I really appreciate your being on this show. I think this is your 21st appearance.
It is. You've been on, forgive my voice, The View had a party last night, and I think I...
The conga line.
Too much cheer. You've been on 25 years, and I've been on 21. So there were 4 years you didn't want me. What did I do?
By the way, I believe, looking at this group, you were the first female anchor, were you not?
I was the first female co-anchor when I first came to ABC from NBC. You see, if I hadn't left, I would have your job today. Do you realize that?
That hadn't occurred to me, but perhaps we could discuss
it. You have nothing to say.
A delightful Chardonnay later. Yes, I don't know.
Anyway,
Brian, you've been a guest. You were a guest on this show many times when you were the White House correspondent, Brian. And you've also been on Stand Up to Cancer. So we're very appreciative that you're here tonight. I really mean it, Brian.
You've been very, very kind to me. And by the way, Larry, what you've just done is what scores of network executives were never able to do. You just snatched airtime away from Barbara Walters, by the way, who was in the middle of a sentence. But as long as it's on me, I'm going to take it, run with it over the goal line, and tell you that this has this table and the one where you're sitting with Bill Maher, which I agree is hard to say. This has been America's kind of confessional, and 25 years is a towering achievement. You're a giant in our business.
Can I take it back now?
Yes, Barbara.
I just want to say that all of us have done interviews. All of us have done world leaders and heads of state and not so heads of state. No one has done more than you. You were my biggest competition. I hate to see you go, but a little part of me says, oh, terrific, now I can get them. But, you know, nobody has done them as well. The week that I was on, I guess this fall, you had Ahmadinejad on, and then Jimmy Carter was on the next night. I mean, and that's just routine for you. So
you'll be so missed. Before I ask Katie, Brian, you mentioned Bill Maher. What do you think of Ryan Seacrest?
A sparkling, still emerging talent. You and I have the same opinion of that young man. It's just such an exciting evening. I mean, just in the green room here to see your next two guests, Star Jones and Julian Assange. It's really, there's a vibe, there's a crackle and energy in the air that's hard to define.
You are nuts.
Brian, take two, hit the right. All right, Katie, you're part of the CNN before... You were part of CNN before I was. I'm honored you returned to the network. Wendy, your good pal, my senior executive producer, tells me you have something to say as well. Katie,
well, you know,
it's yours.
Okay, Larry. Well, we go way back, and of course, Wendy is one of my very closest friends, and I don't know if you guys can show a shot of her, but this is a very emotional night for Wendy because she has loved working with you. so very much, and she's such a wonderful person. And I think I decided, Larry, that I was gonna write you a poem bemoaning the fact that you're leaving your home. What are we to do without our top talker? Here's an ode filled with love from me and Miss Walker. As you hang up your suspenders on your dressing room door, I speak for us all when I say we want more. More of the show that we instantly loved for 25 years, couldn't get enough of. Your unique take on politics, culture and crime, never cutting off guests except for Barbara, always giving them time. You made NAFTA exciting, and that's hard to do. And you scored Paris Hilton's post-jail interview. Sinatra, George Clooney, Clint Eastwood, Bacall, so many stars, I just can't name them all. From Heather Mills' leg to Ross Perot's twang, you always cajole, not harass or harangue. But there were moments when your guests had a cow. Seinfeld wasn't canceled, Larry, but I guess you know that by now. Mike Tyson KO'd without throwing a punch, and you got Miss California's sash in a bunch. You went Gaga for Gaga, Sharon Stone, Janet Jackson. Alas, it was Brando who gave you some action. 8 presidents joined you, from Nixon to Obama, and you brought us each moment of OJ's long drama. Some startling shows I'll never forget. Tammy Faye's Eyes, Ted Haggard's Regret. Your guests made us cry, made us laugh, made us think. Wynonna Judd told you about a God wink. I hadn't heard that before, so I looked the phrase up. It's a miracle, blessing, an overfilled cup. That's what you are. And as old Blue Eyes might say, the best is yet to come, Larry. You did it your way. Congratulations, Larry. That's from Wendy, okay, too.
Thank you all. And Diane, until I get them, you may wear those suspenders on the ABC World News.
I will so wear them with pride and a little bit of eccentricity.
And
you know what I mean.
And a blazer covering them up, Larry.
Something like that. Yeah,
exactly.
Thank you, guys. Thanks very much. A guest who's been here 28 times over the years will join us for the 29th time. We're going to go live to Little Rock, Arkansas, next.